My people, it's your buddy Tack. Today we're going to take a look at the SIG P226 Elite. This firearm I've had since 2011, so that's what, 11 years, and it's been flawless the whole time. This is the 40 S&W version, and we'll go over the technical specs first and get that out of the way. Overall length of this firearm is 7.7 inches. The overall width is 1.5 inches, so it's pretty thick. That's one of my problems with it, and that's mostly the grip itself. The height of it is 5.5 inches. The barrel length is 4.4 inches. The sight radius is 6.3 inches, which is a decent sight radius. And it's about 34 ounces. Now this is the single double action configuration. It also has the SRT trigger, the short reset trigger, which I gotta say, out of all the pistols I've owned, which is around 22 or something now, which ain't a lot, but this is by far the best trigger. Now on double action, it is really good, but man, on that single action, it is just freaking beautiful. Now let's empty this. I did have it racked, but I unloaded it. So, New York 10 round mags, woohoo! Awesome. We'll do a quick breakdown of this. Quick disassembly. Now don't get mad at me, it is dirty. I have been using it. So you just open her up, turn this little lever. That's one thing I like about these SIGs, it's just so easy to take down. Boom. There's your spring and guide rod. It's not captured. And your barrel, just like so. It's very easy to disassemble. The only thing I don't like is you do have to guide this in, but it's not that bad. As long as you're not a super wuss, you know what I'm saying? And I do love how the guide rod is like full length. Look at that. Super beefy. So supposedly, not that I care, but oh, Navy SEALs use it. Yeah, whatever, I really don't give a shit. Excuse my French. So put it back to lock, switch it there. Function check, she's all together. Now this model also has a decocker on it, which I love SIG decockers, they're so quiet. That's it. My Agent K's are like, smack! You think it's going off or something, but it's not. There's your slide release, like I said, your takedown lever. This does have tritium sights. Beautiful rosewood grips on there, they are just beautiful. But they are a little bit slippery. Here it's not, it's got some good traction. You got some stippling on the front. Some stippling on the front of the trigger guard. You have your Picatinny rail there. Forward and rear serrations, which work great. Your mag release, of course. Now I'll show you the trigger. Just check again, check, 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 triple check. So the trigger pull on this, there's the wall right there. It's just that much take up and it's super clean break, super clean. Now, I'll show you the reset. See if I can get you to see this. Short reset trigger, so right about, right there, man, that's it. So that thing is super short. Now it does have a pretty big beaver tail on it. I do like beaver tails. I think they look cool too. It is a little difficult to get up and over this for me. That is the one minus. And like I said, the grip is a little bit fat for me. I have medium to large hands. I usually get a large glove, but I would have to say more on the medium size. So it is a little bit big for me, and I can't reach the mag release without, you know, turning it in my hand a little bit. The slide release I can reach without moving my hand. The decocker, I do have to move my hand too. So it does fit bigger hands a little bit better. Now, like most SIGs, the fit and finish is beautiful on this. I mean, all the seams of the wood and just everything. This thing is such a pretty gun, so beautiful. Okay, got a little target set up down there, 15 yards. Now I'm shooting 165 grain Winchester, just the white box, the regular stuff. Let's see how I do. Just get warmed up. All right. Oh, got to put safety goggles on. Safety first, not last. Have a future, not a past. Hopefully I don't fog up too much. A little cold outside. Let's see what we can do. Okay, 15 yards. I'm just going to take my time, try to be accurate, see how this goes.
Fogging up.
Can take my eyes off. Hey, I'm just shooting paper.
It's not like I'm shooting metal. Wow, was that 10?
I don't even know if I loaded that right. I went too fast. Let's go see how terrible I did. This is gonna be bad. Oh crap, I see two in the lower left-hand corner. This ain't gonna be good.
Okay, that was terrible.
Hey, even your man messes up. I went too fast. Down and to the left, what does that mean, guys? That means you're flinching a little bit. Mellow out, Tack, chill out. Let's try that again. Let me just mark those targets. Oh God, I hope I didn't shoot 10 because I only see 6. I need some more practice. Hit the stop button, stupid. Come on, stupid, I know you can do it. Hit the Okay, I'm almost out of these kind of bullets, so I just got 8 shots. I'm gonna go a little slower, try not to screw up so much. That was my first shot of the day. Not that that's an excuse or nothing. This thing is really easy to shoot though. I mean, since it's a full size and it's kind of heavy, the recoil is like nothing. It's just me sucking. So let's try this again. I'll go a little bit slower this time.
Okay, 15 yards. I gotta remember my grip.
I think I did better. Let's go look. Guess the moral of the story is don't suck like me. Practice more. Oh, okay, a little bit better. What did I say? I shot 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. At least I hit every time. Huh. Terrible. There we go this time. At least I wasn't flinching as much. Whoops, get the camera on it, stupid. I had 2 way down here, so I was still screwing up. But at least the rest were closer. So not as bad. A tiny bit of redemption. Okay, this time we're gonna try something I usually don't have luck with. These little Liberty Defense. I don't know if you see that. Really light zippers. I can't remember what these are. If they're 90 grain or what. I know they're super light. And out of everything I shoot with these things, just they're not very accurate. Hey, could be me though. You just seen those two groups. Terrible. So, yeah, let's give it a shot, shall we? Let's pray, shall we? Yeah, let's pray. Okay, so 8 shots again. I'm gonna take my time. All right. Whew.
There's a big flash.
These things are freaking hot. See that fireball every time? I don't know. I don't totally trust these things, man. They just seem a little too hot, but let's go see the suck. Oh boy. What did I say? 8 bullets, right? All right, let's see. A couple okay ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh God. 6. Really? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, there's 2 there. 5, 6. Set. I missed once. Oh, big surprise. I missed. Ooh. Those things are freaking hot, though. I don't totally trust those things. I feel like it's just going to blow my gun up or something. Okay, we moved up to 10 yards. Get a little closer.
I'm going to put my shades on. I don't trust these darn bullets. I don't think I'm going to buy these again. But yeah, let's do 10 more shots and hope everything goes okay.
10 yards. That was a flinch. Man, I can't see. I am so fogged up.
I was trying to fight through the fogging.
I think I got two more. Nope, just one more.
Yeah, I just couldn't do it. I kept trying, looked through the fog. I couldn't do it. Duh. That's the trials and tribulation of wearing a darn mask. Yep.
Let's go see. Okay. Low again, but let's see. One. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Really? Shit. Oh, well, I did find one of my other ones. I said I missed one or two, and it was down there. You could tell by how the papers creased. But I think I missed again, at least once. So, yeah, the gun is great. I mean, it works flawless. Never had a problem. Had it for 11 years, like I said. My hand loads did better than a lot of these factory ones, but there you go. The primers, get that to focus. See, they are pretty flattened out, ain't they? So excessive pressure. Yeah, I don't think I'll be buying the Liberty Defense again.
Now we're back to Tactical Castle, so we can wrap this vid up. So overall, what do I think? Fit and finish, top notch. Pretty wise is probably my prettiest gun, or at least one of my prettiest. It is a great gun. It's flawless. I've never had a problem with it, even with hand loads. Maybe that wasn't the best representation, is that how you say it, of accuracy, because come on, you're dealing with me. And that's why I want to show, I'm not one of them fake YouTubers where, oh, let's take a clip of me shooting. Oh, that sucked. Let's redo it. I'm just going to show you the real me. I'm just an average shooter. I hope I'm at least average. Probably not. But anyways, the gun itself, minus me, the suck, this thing is awesome. My only flaw is the grip size for me. Now, like, say, would I recommend this to you? If you got big hands, sure. If they're medium to large, like kind of in the middle like mine are, it's a little too big for me. Like I said, I can't reach all the controls without spinning it in my hand. It functions flawlessly. I know it's more accurate than that because my hand loads and stuff. And I have hit 70 yards with it. Not every time, because you're talking to me. But I have hit 70 yards with it, which is really great for a 4.4-inch barrel. The night sights are awesome. I mean, everything about it is awesome. It's just too big for me. Now, back in the day, this was my favorite gun. And not because of the Navy SEALs. I'm not one of these guys that ride coattails. Oh, there's a Navy SEAL. Let me beat off. I don't give a... The only thing I'm beating off is to some chicks. You don't try it. No, don't say that. We got to cut that out of the video. sorry about that. But yeah, I don't give a crap who has it, who uses it. I'm not going to buy something just because Joe Schmo has it. I don't give a crap what he has. I'm going to buy something because I like it. Sure, your recommendations might have a little bit of weight and, oh, okay, maybe I'll check it out. But I'm not going to buy something just because you have it, because I really don't care what you have. But, you know, I just want what I want, and you should do the same. You get what you want, what makes you happy. Like I said, this was my favorite. It's not anymore. I love the gun, but it's really heavy. But you've seen with the recoil, if you watch the video, it didn't jump much. You know, even with the hotter loads, it didn't jump much. It was a big ball of fire, but it's very controllable. The weight does make it controllable. I just think it's a little heavy on my belt. You know, I'm a midget, so it's a little bit heavy for me. And it's just a little bit too big on the grip. It's a good shape, It's just a little bit too big. So yeah, it's not my favorite anymore. So would I recommend it? If you have a big hand, I would. Give it a shot. Or maybe test out one of your friends. Then you might be like, yeah, or nah, I don't really like it. But it is a great gun. So I just wanted to give you an honest review on my P226. And I hope everybody's doing good out there. Until the next time we meet.